France is celebrating its new leader tonight. Centrist Emmanuel Macron defeated far-right nationalist Marie Le Pen. Macron got 65% of the votes, leaving just 35% to Le Pen. And as Wendy Gillette reports from New York, Macron plans to fight for a unified Europe.
A joyful roar erupted in Paris as supporters of Emmanuel Macron learned he'll be the next president of France.
Ses intérêts vitaux, son image.
In his acceptance speech, Macron said he would protect the interests of France and Europe and fight against terrorism. The campaign had some similarities to the U.S. presidential election in November. A centrist candidate whose platform centered on European unity and an open economy, running against far-right leader Marine Le Pen, who focused on a message of anti-immigration and nationalism, threatening to take France out of the EU. Hacking was also part of France's election. On Friday, Macron was the target of a widespread hacking and data dump online. But it didn't seem to affect the results. Projections show Macron winning by a larger-than-expected margin. Le Pen conceded the race shortly after the results were announced, saying she spoke to Macron to congratulate him and wish him success. She also called for patriots to join a new political force. There were fears that violence could interfere with Sunday's voting. A bomb scare forced an evacuation at the famous Louvre Museum. But the tens of thousands of police officers on duty nationwide served as a deterrent, and no other problems were reported as French citizens headed to the polls. Macron, who's 39 years old, will be the country's youngest leader since Napoleon. Wendy Gillette for CBS News.